Alright. So this is gonna be my very first movie review. So basically the film I'm gonna be reviewing is called The Whale, directed by Darren Aronofsky, starring Brendan Fraser. And it pretty much delivers a very sentimental and touching exploration of a lot of different complicated themes as well as characters. Now, the first thing let me get into the puzzle too. Hold on a while. It's a puzzle too. We gotta make the puzzles right. So I gotta look for the. Oh, these are a little different. These pieces are a little different. Hold on. And the side pieces and all that good stuff. So that's what I'm gonna start out with. But yeah, okay, so the first thing I want to talk about this film that I think is just absolutely amazing is the location and how it's 90%, if not more, it's filmed in one location, being his Charlie's apartment. And I just think it's dope that you don't need all these fancy locations and fancy places to tell a story. And man, it being primarily in his apartment is a big part of the story too, because it really exaggerates the fact that this person is extremely secluded and extremely just by himself. He doesn't have the luxury to go to different places. He's too big. So we're put in that same space. And this also goes on to my next point, the aspect ratio. Not gonna go into detail about what aspect ratio means and what that choice, how that may change a film. I'm just gonna talk about the choice that is made for this specific film, which it is in 4:3. For a person like Charlie to be as big as he is, 4:3 is the perfect representation of that, because it, just like the location where we're stuck in this place, this a small apartment for majority of the film, us being in 4:3, it kind of puts him inside of a box, and we have this big figure, claustrophobic and kind of trapped. And he's always normally the largest thing in the frame. So I think it's just kind of exaggerated with those two decisions. I'm struggling on this puzzle. I'm not gonna cap. Okay. And this is all a great example of visual storytelling. Okay, so my next point, the performance. Brendan Fraser won Best Actor for his performance and his depiction of Charlie, and it's well deserved, because his performance is actually amazing, and it's a big part of why this film hits the way it does.
These amazing, honest things that you wrote, they matter.
His award is definitely well deserved, and it definitely had an effect on everyone in that theater. Must add that Sadie Sink, the girl from Stranger Things, she did a great job as well. She really captured that like asshole type role where you don't like her, but you can kind of, by the end, you kind of empathize with her. Okay, the themes. Man, a big reason why I enjoy this film is all the themes that it kind of dives into. I'm not going to go into depth into all of them, being that one, this is my first movie review, so I'm not really sure how I should go about it, so I'm just kind of like winging it. And two, I will be talking for days, to be honest. Charlie is a very extreme case of someone who stopped caring. You see that with a lot of things that he says, like he doesn't want to go to the hospital, even though he has the money to do so. He just really doesn't care anymore. So I think it's really more about like mental health than it is strictly obesity. I think it's more about depression and being able to deal with loss these themes are so big with Charlie, really other characters in the film as well. He basically let grief consume him, I guess, and he consumed a lot of food. Yeah, for Charlie, feels like everything he does is wrong. This really is apparent with one of my favorite scenes in the film, and I really just love the blocking of it.
Okay. We can't give up on her.
You already gave up on her. You gave up on her when she was 8 years old.
I wish I could have been a part of her life, Mary. A part of both of your lives.
Go to the hospital. You have money. Just go to the hospital.
You both know that that money is for Ellie. But beyond that, I need to know that she's gonna have a decent life where she cares about people and other people care about her. And she's gonna be okay.
I need to go.
Mary, she doesn't
I have, to go.
Have anyone else. I need to know that I have done one thing right with my life.
I think the blocking sets up the close-up so perfectly and so beautifully. His performance is amazing, so I think everything just goes hand in hand. The composition, the performance, lighting, editing, everything. Charlie's only hope for redemption is through his daughter Ellie, basically redeeming people for her. But he knows that he needs to redeem how she feels about people. That's his purpose. And Thomas is an epitome of make a mistake, there's gonna be second chances, there's gonna be room for redemption. Thomas kind of shows that you can't save everybody. Everybody doesn't want to be saved. You know, this is real life. This is, of course, it's not based off a true story, but this is real. This is not no make-believe shit. Like, this could really be somebody's story out there. And Charlie's one of those people that he doesn't care to be saved. So, yeah. And I think, like, there's a lot of intricates in this film, too. Like, the role that the essay plays and how everything is kind of a subtle buildup. And everything kind of comes together by the end. But yeah, I think that's pretty much my review. In terms of rating, I'm gonna give it a highly recommend. I don't think this film is for everyone, but it's a great movie. I believe that it'll have an effect on anybody that watches it. Yeah, if you got to this point, fuck with me. Like, comment, subscribe, all that. Let me know what I should watch next.